think you want to hear what I have to say. But I'm going to tell you anyways. I'm going to tell you a story. And it's my story, and it's yours. But it doesn't belong to either one of us. This is the story of the students with Greek letter sweatshirts and team jackets and bonfire shirts.
This is the story of what happens on the weekends when the professors drive away and the campus closes its eyes.
This is the story of a girl who wakes up one morning with memories only of the previous afternoon.
This is the story of the boy who can't tell his parents what it took to become a brother.
This is the story of the girl who waits in a room to tell her story for the 100th time to the 100th person who cannot help her.
Every story has a beginning, but this one has many. It begins in different rooms with different people, colliding with each other in different ways. So let's start from the floor up, so to speak. Let's start in the basement.
Thank you. sometimes the wrong things happen. Sometimes we lose a little innocence and we lose a little self. Sometimes we get a little lost.
So we tell ourselves it really doesn't matter. We tell ourselves that touching is just touching. And sex, it's just motion. Intimacy is just a social construct. And consent, it's just a formality.
Something bad happened to me once.
Committee hearing, case number 23-23.
Actually, I kept on playing pong with this girl, and we kept losing because she was really bad.
Anyway, we ended up playing like four games of tree, which in retrospect was kind of a bad idea because he was awful at pong. Like, couldn't even keep it on the table awful.
So we just kept on getting more and more out of it, and one second I'm leaning over the table trying to finish my half cup.
Anyway, there was this one part of the night where he stared at me really intensely and said, "I kind of remember your name."
And the next moment, it's 6:30 in the morning, and I am lying in bed with my clothes off.
And it was hysterical.
But this random girl passed out next to me, and I don't know if she's okay or whatever.
I think he was brother. Or shit, I hope he was brother. Because we went upstairs to someone's room. Hopefully his. And I guess we hooked up.
And so I got up and started to put my clothes on and everything. And I must have woken her up because she was like trying to find her clothes and stuff. And we were both just kind of standing there because she didn't really seem to know what had happened.
Anyway, next thing I know, it's morning, and he's like, "Do you want to stay?" I'm like, "No."
And finally she was like, "I'm a tenant." And I was like, "Okay." And then she just left.
It was really funny and completely sketchy. But whatever, it's college. We're both adults.
Honestly, the whole thing was just really awkward. I don't know.
This story has a lot of characters, so you might not be able to keep track. But let's simplify.
Let's make it all about bad guys and good guys. And we'll put the bad guys in bad shirts, and they'll say bad things and do bad things, and then everything will be perfectly clear.
Because we love clarity here. There's safety in clarity. You don't have to ask who, you don't have to ask why.
But what if we did? What if we tried to make something understandable? Could we do it without making it acceptable or forgivable? How?
Well, we'd have to ask questions. We'd have to really look. We'd have to really see. Do we even want to?
When I tried to escape out the back door of the basement, he yanked them out of my hands. The music was blasting, And everyone was chanting, short hitter, short hitter. So I ran up the stairs and I grabbed his arm. And he has this awful grin on his face. Okay, here are your keys, you slut. And he hit me in the face. That's where I got this and this.
I'm 10.
Hey,
and I'm a 75. And I had one hell of a good time in this house. My real education took place right here in this room. This is why I learned lessons about friendship, loyalty, trust, about being a man. All right, okay, I know I did some crazy shit when I was a student, and you know, I'm not proud of it. But after all, isn't that what college is all about? To figure out not only who you want to be, but who you don't want to be? I'll tell you the truth. Those were the best years of my life. Statistics, sexual assaults on our campus more than doubled in 2010, and alcohol and drug violations increased by 23%.
But there's no need to be alarmed. These numbers don't necessarily signal a growing problem at the college. The increase in reported cases suggests an environment where victims feel more comfortable coming forward. When considering this broader context, ours is an incredibly safe and secure campus. Now, over the last few months, the media has been painting a grossly misleading portrait of life at the college. Sexual assault, binge drinking, date rape drugs, hazing are all inescapable realities of 21st century campus life.
It's the comparing of statistics among our peer institutions that creates this distorted picture. This is not New Haven. And New Haven is not Providence. Cambridge is not Ithaca. And Ithaca is not Philadelphia. Princeton is not Morningside Heights. And Morningside Heights is not Amherst. And this is not New Haven. And New Haven is not Providence.
I do not have the power to intervene on this issue. So, in the meantime, it is important to remember, change will not come overnight.
Thank you.
talk to me. She take a shot to me. Once a moment. Kids don't breathe. Looking for what I can see. Without tight to me. She'll take a shot to me. He can now fly to Dubai. He can now fly to Dubai. He can now fly to.
Make an advance in front of our brothers or our sisters. Who's watching us, we want to know. Who's looking?
But what are we really looking at? What are we watching in the rooms that we walk into? What do we see in the people around us? We're around 1,000 stories every morning and another 1,000 every evening. We're around tragedies and comedies, moments of celebration and moments of violence.
Can we always tell which is which?
Too long.